How you gonna put on your ankle?
Thank you. Thank you. a record this past fall in Los Angeles, not where we live. We've been doing this Watkins Family Hour gig. It generally is a residency, aside from one tour that we did several years ago. We play in Los Angeles almost exclusively, and once a month at this little club that we call home, called Largo, and we do this. The Largo fans. Nice. Well, anyway, so that's usually our gig as like an off, like a it's like a hobby gig. From our day jobs, which is whatever other album that we're touring, but we made a record that we wrote together for the first time. We'd never written as a duo before, and we wrote and recorded this record last year. We'll play a bunch of new songs on the boat for you guys tonight, and or this week.
Yep.
And here's another one of those.
Thank you.
playing the bass.
Still breaks his heart. kind of breaks my heart, and I know it breaks all our hearts, especially in our country. We have to face that kind of thing every day. So this is a song I wrote about called Say Old Playmate.
Tell me.
that love conquers all. Do another one right now that I wrote with Mary Gauthier and Leslie Satcher. We did a songwriting workshop together. It was wild. They put us together the first day in this workshop, me and the two of them. And you know, Mary is a great LGBTQ activist, hardcore progressive, and Leslie is a Trump supporter who thinks he was prophesied in the Old Testament. So we got in there and we had to find something to write a song about. And the beautiful thing was that we said, okay, we got some different viewpoints here. What do we agree on, man? This is not the song I'm going to do, but we did write a song. It was like, well, we can all agree that the opioid thing is a nightmare that we all want to deal with. We can all agree that veterans shouldn't be homeless, you know? And we actually found some common ground, and it felt really good to do that. But we also wrote a straight-up heartbreak love song, because everybody goes through that. So this is that song. It's called When Someone You Know Becomes Someone You Knew. What might have been.
We're gonna take a little journey over here to see you five people. Hello. We'll play a couple little songs over here. And I don't want to hurt the recording. Oh dear. Do a little Mike Nesmith song for you guys.
Yeah, so this is a Michael Nesmith song. We grew up, Sarah's and my mom was obsessed with Linda Ronstadt, and mostly her greatest hits. She had the greatest hits volume 2 tape in our old Jeep Cherokee for about a good 5 years that was just always playing. And we came to loathe these songs as kids, younger kids. But then we grew up and realized that there are some amazing gems on there. This is one of them. She always picked such incredible covers. A lot of people know, you know, her versions of songs more than the actual original versions. I don't know about this one, but this is definitely the one I know.
I think you would definitely say this is her song.
The guy who who runs that club in Los Angeles that we play at all the time. His name is Flanagan. He's an Irish fellow who is very, very good at putting people together and also just suggesting songs to people learn. This is one that he told Sarah and I we should learn. No? Oh, scratch all that for a later date. Sarah's gonna talk while I tip.
Yeah. Good stuff.
Foundation of Watkins Family Hour shows. We'll do that one later. But this is a tune that Sean wrote. It's on another one from the new record. It's coming out in April. And it's always funny naming instrumental songs. I don't know if you've tried it, but it's sometimes can feel very arbitrary. Just putting a name to a melody that doesn't have words. But this one actually means something. It's nice to have an instrumental with a name that means something. You're not gonna know what it means, doesn't matter. But we do, and that's enough. It's called Snow Tunnel.
After a not so great breakup. It wasn't horrible, but I made it sound a lot worse than it was.
So are we supposed to feel sorry for you?
I don't know, I shouldn't have told you that. It was really bad. And I didn't play electric guitar in the book version, but I wanted to. Anyway, now I get to. Not that I couldn't have.
Thank you. also want me into. Saying we're very different people, so dear, I hope you find somebody more.
This is really kind of a surreal thing because I remember buying a Nickel Creek album years and years ago when they played at Riverbend in Chattanooga. I've not even had a chance to tell them the story, but I bought the album and like was obsessed with the whole thing, especially Lighthouse. And it was me and my mom's favorite song. It was the first song that I ever cried to every time I heard it. So. Anyway, it's just really amazing to be part of this set, be part of this day. So, yeah, thanks for coming out and listening. This is a song that's going to be on an album that will be coming out later this year. The song's called Firewater. I bought every spirit and I'm still laying it.
fight, water won't save me. I'll forsake the path of filth, please.
Be on the new record, and it's called The Worst. It's a love song, so you can probably put two and two together and figure out how it went. But at any rate, Dirk Powell recorded and played on this song with me a couple years ago in Louisiana, and so this is the perfect moment to be able to do this song. So, yeah, thanks so much.
Nothing else can breathe.
Thank you.
Perform it before recording, and if we did, it was just like maybe one or two times to a few people. And so it's been fun to kind of debut them in a way on the boat here and figure out how to play them for you all. It's a safe, feels like a safe place.
Shut up and don't talk about this song. Here we go. It's an old Charlie Jordan song. Keep it clean.
Water.